the same parties that were involved in the five girls or six girls that were killed in the 1960s on Central Avenue at the 4500 block of Central Avenue in an upstairs apartment of the same families that were involved in the 11 men found on Imperial Avenue. The same judges are involved. The same correction officers are involved. The same deputy sheriffs are involved. The same public defender's office involved. The same prosecutor's office are involved in these series of murders that are using the electronic voice to call system. I repeat, the following families are involved in a series of murders from 1987 to 2012. The relevant are convicted or arrested for their assistance in committing crimes inside the human civil brain, for tormenting human beings, making telephone harassment, false telephone calls, harassment transmission of a conversation already recorded or pre-recorded after a conversation. The judges has personal knowledge of this system being operated from the 1950s to the day of Judge Sarah Hopper. Detective Mark Cross, who used the same device in the Carver Housing Projects during the 60s, on a Jerome Wagner. The Detective Mark Cross told Jerome Wagner the smoke crack, cell crack, bit of fat, and will kill herself. About 2 weeks later, the man killed himself because a cross had been plummeting inside his head. Ron Wagner was a neighbor of Newt Adams, who had got home to a little kid. Programmed him to kill somebody in the future, he killed his wife. Marshall Bell, also from the old Carver Housing Project, was programmed to kill at a future date. He killed his wife. Jesse Pimp, who was a CHMA employee in the maintenance department, was told by Kennard McDuffie that one day he was going to make him kill somebody with a voice score machine. He later Jesse killed one of his girlfriends at the Buckeye Laundromat in Cleveland, Ohio. They got on to a Charles Dickens Jr., harassed him when he moved to Mount Pleasant area, and made him kill his girlfriend. They got on to Albert Brunner, made him do robberies, like they did when the Broadway that stayed in the Oakley Homes part of the projects in the central area. They got a hold of the Detective Artie Leitner and programmed him while he was resident at the old Carver Housing Project during the 60s. And told him that one day they would make him kill a male policeman. Well, the policeman named it Melvin Carter, who was also a friend of mine who often visited me about what they were going to do to him. And he was going to do the killing. Jesse Prim was a friend of Kennard McDuffie's City Municipal Court Records. Of the attorney, Kennard McDuffie, who handled the cases for Jesse Prim. Senator Jones was also tapped to the machine to tell lies through her face and to obey the corrupt system that run through the court system. Little Adams was a friend of David Phillips, who lived a couple of doors down to the guy that owned to made him kill somebody on East 55th Street. They tormented a Mr. Gray, who was serving as Harvey Gray. build a rear window. They're coming in to take on his kids. And coming in to kill himself. If he would not allow them to have one of their children to be used in their criminal system. Detective Nathaniel Baden. You know, you go to this park sometime during every day the 70s. And told Mrs. Alberta Brumley that he was going to the house and start a lie and took her son's life and get him involved in that circle. Her son ended up murdering somebody because of them talking to his head, making him violent, like they're trying to be me. Like to be a little island brother called to that. They like to be a whole family when they do it. Like they did the son of Morgan Smith, a resident of the old Carver Park here in the 40s, 50s, and the 60s. That he coming in them and they hung him. They told Rachel Roby, another Carver Park resident. She had to be about 89 years old, how they were going to make her feel crap and sew her body. And if she didn't obey, years later they were going to find a way to kill her son on the west side. It took place. A couple years ago, her son was found dead. That conversation came from Patricia Blackman, George Blackman. Other conversations came from Curtis Watkins. Some conversations came from Edward Fitzgerald. Some voices come from girls and chicks who used in the scene. And others, crackheads that they appointed, the whole conversation to torment their victims. They hired court records in the Anthony Seward case. Anthony Seward was also a resident of the Central area and often visited the old Carver housing projects. So they had programmed him to kill. The detectives in Sugar Heights and Cleveland are in cooperation with holding information of concerned murders in this racial score system that is run in the city of Cleveland and farther throughout Cuyahoga County. The former deputy, the former sheriff, J.T. McFarland, was also, his family lived in that residence area of Carver Park. So he had contact with Curtis Watkins. So they got a hold to his dealer, Colleen, and started making her smoke crack cocaine. Most of the residents lost their kids. They were then beating them to death, tormenting them, or using their physical body to hurt others. They steal your mail and they illegally tap your phones and torment the citizens. They use their families over and over again. Calvin Gray, Minister News, Cleveland.